Most houses will have some sort of programming, usually to manage heating and hot water, whether a simple mechanical clock device or a more sophisticated electronic programmer. The benefits are that heat and hot water are available as and when required, and energy is not wasted when the house is empty. Domotics takes this concept very much further. It's the application of building automation to domestic houses. Many more appliances and applications can be controlled, not just heating, ventilation and air conditioning. But lighting can go on and off automatically when a room is occupied or empty. Or the lights can come on, the curtains open, the coffee machine starts brewing and the radio begins playing when it's time to get up. If it's a hot day and the sun is very bright, sensors can trigger blinds to be drawn, awnings extended, and maybe ventilation started to cool the thermal mass of the house. If one of your children has left the fridge open or the washing machine is leaking, the system can sense the increased use of electricity or water and alert you. Once the house is empty, your robotic vacuum cleaner can switch on and start cleaning. If the house plants are getting dry, they can be watered automatically. If you're away from home and an intruder breaks in or there's a fire, an alarm could be sent to your smartphone or tablet or to the emergency services. If you're coming home early to an empty house, you can use your phone to tell the heating system to warm the place up before you arrive. It's no longer just a matter of programming to suit your requirements during the day, but of responding. Responding to remote commands. Responding to changes in weather. Sensing and responding to events in the house, as well as adding to the comfort and convenience enjoyed by the householder, Domotics also reduces energy demands. Power can also be scheduled. For example, heavy electrical loads such as washing can coincide with maximum output from solar photovoltaic panels fitted on the roof. At the heart of the Domotics system will be the controller, either a home computer or dedicated control unit. This will have interfaces so that the householder can set their requirements either at home or remotely. There will be sensors to measure changes in temperature, electricity demand, water flow or daylight, and to detect motion. There will be actuators, solenoids, electric motors, motorized valves and so on, so the system can respond to commands or changes to the environment in or around the house. These can all be connected by wiring or through a wireless system, and can use internet protocols to make it compatible with remote devices. The SML House is a pilot project by the Cardinal Herrera University Valencia, which was entered in the solar decathlon competition. The aim was to make the house self-sufficient, or even a net generator of energy. Photovoltaic panels cover the roof and also the south-facing wall of the building. For the Domotics, the team adopted KNX. KNX is an international building control standard for intelligent buildings. It can be used to integrate and program a range of products and appliances from different manufacturers. Over a simple network, a single software tool provides seamless control.
La parte o el corazón importante de la vivienda o el cerebro de la vivienda es el sistema de control. Que es a través de un bus de KNX, es domótica estándar, utilizamos elementos de KNX que juntamos entre ellos, programamos, pero además lo que nos permitimos es volcar la información del KNX a un ordenador, de forma que a través de la inteligencia de un ordenador somos capaces de mantener en funcionamiento tanto la climatización como el resto de tareas básicas de la vivienda. Este ordenador incorpora además una red neuronal que te permite hacer un análisis mucho más avanzado de predicciones de tiempo, predicciones de futuros estados de la vivienda, control de los sistemas de los electrodomésticos. Es decir, la vivienda a través del bus de KNX recibe la información, se la transmite al ordenador y este es capaz de reflexionar y entender los hábitos normales de un usuario. Nosotros desarrollamos algunas plataformas de medida, hay elementos adicionales que únicamente tienen sentido para desarrollarlos en concurso. Nosotros necesitamos incrementar mucho las necesidades de una vivienda en cuanto a material eléctrico para concurso.
A variety of methods can be used to send digital data between the various devices and appliances under the KNX protocol. These include the X10 standard, which uses the 220-volt mains wiring to carry signals. This minimizes the amount of cabling required to install a domotic system. X10 was originally developed by Pico Electronics in Scotland in the 1970s. It works by encoding data onto 120 Hz carrier wave, which is superimposed in bursts onto the 50 or 60 Hz alternating current in the mains electricity supply. Signals can also be sent wirelessly. The Zigbee and Z-Wave technologies are particularly associated with domotics. The SML House team chose the KNX EIB, or European Installation Bus, a single cable installed alongside the mains power circuits throughout the house, combined with Z-Wave to control the lighting. All elements of the SML house, solar power generation, lighting, heating, cooling and appliances are integrated through these systems to give the greatest possible energy efficiency.